Okay, this is a hilarious article from WCCF Tech, and this is going to get you laughing. Titanfall 2 designer says this: Switch is so underpowered, third-party support will be no different than the Wii U. Well, that certainly takes the wind out of Nintendo's sails for anyone who is hoping for third-party, which would probably be nobody. I think anyone who's buying the Nintendo Switch already either A, has a PC, or B, has one, if not both, of the other consoles. But let's go into it anyway. More and more industry professionals are reacting to Nintendo Switch reveal, be it via Twitter or interviews of all kinds. For example, Respawn's Mohamed Alviar, that's the best I can do, who worked as senior designer on Titanfall and Titanfall 2, talked about the Nintendo Switch's new console, and a video cast appeared on YouTube's Drunk Tech Review channel. This is where it gets pretty fucking raw. That's why I like this one. Let's see, this is a direct quote from him, by the way. I'm gonna tell you, I was excited about it because Nintendo's been in such a niche market recently, like catering to the handheld, and I'm going to be honest with you, the kids. They've been so underpowered in terms of hardware that they don't have the support of third parties, because they are all making games for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, and the Nintendo Switch is no different. When asked by Drunk Tech's review host whether Titanfall 2 could be hypothetically ported to Switch, Alevi replied, "Fuck no. No, you're not going to be able to fit Titanfall 2. That's the same Zelda for Wii U." He laughs, basically. Recently, Gearbox's CEO Randy Pitchford stated that Borderlands 3 will most likely never launch on the Switch because of differing priorities. Third-party support has been Nintendo's thorn in the heel ever since the days of the Nintendo 64. Yeah, because they kept doing cartridge-based shit when everybody else moved to compact discs. And they were fucking expensive as hell. I hated the 64. I mean, I loved playing Super Mario. I liked the kart games. Fucking GoldenEye was like a revelation at the time, but God, this shit was expensive. It was like $74 for Pokemon. And you had to like hunt down the Pokemon and take the pictures. Bullshit, dude. My sister had one. That fucking sucked cock. Anyway, ever since the Wii, though, their home consoles have been also vastly underpowered when compared to Sony's and Microsoft's, which made third-party support even more complicated to get, since developers would have to substantially rework their games before porting them. Nintendo's preliminary list of partners was quite promising, although the company is definitely trying hard to overcome the historic hurdles, I was about to say blunders. Reggie Fizamara recently explained how they're trying to create the perfect environment for game studios, thanks to the support of established engines like Unity and Unreal. Unity's a joke. Will there be enough third-party support for the console due to launch on March 3rd? Nintendo doing classic Nintendo moves. I mean, the problem with Nintendo, if we want to get real between me and you, is that Nintendo's run by old men with old ideas. They're still treating gaming like it's a kiddie market, when the gaming industry right now is predominantly 18 to 40 year olds, because frankly, we are the generation of guys who, if I have to quote Fight Club, I fucking will.
The middle children of history, man. No purpose or place. We have no Great War, no Great Depression. Our Great War is a spiritual war. Our Great Depression is our lives. We've all been raised on television to believe that one day we'd all be millionaires and movie gods and rock stars, but we won't. We're slowly learning that fact. We're very, very pissed off.
It was one of the great quotes. I know I paraphrased it poorly, but run with me. That's what Nintendo needs to fucking understand. It isn't little kids that are the big drawing point of video games anymore. It's adults. It's mainly adult males, but there are adult females still in the gaming, but predominantly we're talking adult males, 18 to 30 something, because they, more than anybody, need a motherfucking escape from the minutia of life, everyday life, paying bills, being yelled at, being treated like crap, realizing all your dreams aren't coming true. It's Dad who wants to play Mario Sunshine, not little Billy. Little Billy's in his room making up new memes while watching pornography and calling everyone a faggot on YouTube. It's his father downstairs trying to recapture his childhood through the magic of Mario. God damn it, Shuhei Yoshida, why don't you understand?
Gundam is the wrong Asian man again, you racist.
Damn you, Akira Toriyama. Wait, that's the guy who made fucking Dragon Ball Z, I think. Damn you, Matsushi. Nope, that's the fucking dude who is the samurai. The legendary samurai. Fuck. Alright, hold on. Let me look up who the fuck the head of Nintendo is right now. Head of Nintendo. God fucking cock. Damn you, Tatsumi Kimishima. Why don't you understand these facts? God, it took me forever to figure out that dude's name. Thank God for Google. That being said, Nintendo is still chasing the mobile market. They're never going to beat the mobile market, ever. They should just stop. They keep catering to children, and frankly, kids right now give more of a blind fuck about Minecraft than they do about Mario. I mean, really. I mean, come on, Nintendo. And they're riding off of nostalgia. Riding the cock of nostalgia into fucking oblivion. If the Switch does not do well, this will be the end of Nintendo. This will kill Nintendo as a console maker, which would be sad, just like when Sega died as a console maker. But on the other hand, this will probably force Nintendo to make their games third party, and you could probably play Mario on the PC with mind-blistering graphics. But we'll see. I mean, I'm just being hypothetical here. Like, if this flops, Nintendo's gonna be like Sega, you know, up in the air, giving us these fucking shitty-ass rebrands of Mario. Oh, you mean gamers are now older men? Okay, we make Mario Sex Party. Just kidding. But for real, this does really suck. The only people that are going to get Nintendo are diehard Nintendo fans. People who have disposable income. You know, people who have the money and they're just like, well, I really want to play Zelda or Mario. Like, those are the big selling points. People who do not have disposable income and are not diehard Nintendo fans are looking at the Switch lethargically. Nigga, same old Nintendo bullshit. Whoopee, they're gonna go for a gimmick, more of this bullshit, and really, they're just shooting themselves in the foot. They really are. There are people who disagree with me, but this is my personal opinion. As someone who isn't in love with Nintendo, that does have this disposable income, I'm not buying this shit. You know, as much as I would like to play a Zelda game, I don't like it enough to plunk down $300 and some plus tax and the game to play this Zelda, which is open world. And if we're keeping it real, it may be open world, but it looks pretty damn bland. I'm kind of getting those sort of same feelings I got after playing Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain, for a little while. It's like, wait a minute, there isn't going to be any battles between the Russians and the Afghanistanians. What the fuck is the point then? I mean, really, what the fuck? That was a huge just opportunity missed. It would have been great to actually see some sort of big battles going on between the fucking two warring factions. Instead, all you ever did was the same shit. And granted, you could attack in a situation in different ways each time, but really, the draw was gone. But I will do a video on Metal Gear Solid later. I'm gonna call it Buyer's Remorse Part 2, The Phantom Wallet Crunch. But Zelda Breath of the Wild looks like an open world game that's going to be vast and empty. I don't know why the Japanese are doing this, in the sense of even Final Fantasy, what, 15 or whatever the hell it's called, that's open world too, but it seems kind of a barren open world. It's just a trend they're following, and that's just not a selling point for me. Mario, we all know how that's going to play out, so really, screw it. I don't know about you. Maybe you're willing to give Nintendo a chance, but not me. I'm not willing to give them almost $400 to say, let's see if you change my mind, Nintendo. Screw that. I have $400. It can go elsewhere to more enjoyable endeavors, like adult fantasy camp. I'm not going to tell you about it because it's a secret. I've told you too much. It's like Fight Club. Anyway, screw this. I'm going to go because if I don't, I'm going to rant and rave endlessly about Nintendo. You know the whole spiel. I can't ask you to give more of a fuck than me. If you feel this is worthy of a subscription, feel free. And if you like the way I rant and yell about things, I have a channel dedicated solely to my loud mouthery. You can click the little thingy at the bottom of the screen there. So if you dig me just shooting off at the mouth and keeping it real, that's the place to go. If you like me to be somewhat tethered and restrained, stay right here, because this is as clean as I get. Oh! Damn it! I hit my desk wrong. I didn't even mean to hit the desk. I was trying to leave. Fuck! Fuckity fuck fuck.